Yo, what's poppin', all my official chickens? It's me, Ty. I can't talk right now because I got a little tea taken out. That's right, guys. Yep, I got a little tea taken out. So, I'm not gonna talk yet. I'm gonna wait until my mouth isn't numb anymore. So, yeah, bye, guys.
Hey, what's up, boys and girls? I am feeling a lot better. I can still talk, but I sound really super depressed, but I'm not, so don't worry. So recently, I challenged myself to build two completely different houses in Lego. I built a really super poor, ugly, just very, very crappy looking one, and the other one is really super well off, rich, fancy, extravagant, luxurious. I want to put both of these builds into one video, so I figured let's take a look at what it's like to live the poor lifestyle versus the rich lifestyle in Lego. We got no time to waste. Let's get right into this video.
To be honest, I love living in a trailer home. The money? Well, that's all long gone. I spent it on donating to streamers. Let me think. I donated $20,000 to Mr. Beast just to send a message that said 2% milk is better than 1%. And I also spent $10,000 on a girl stream because I thought she was cute.
So for my poor house, I was originally going to recreate like a dirt hut. I just went after something a little more relatable. And these are trailer houses. I've never actually built a trailer home before, so this was kind of fun to work with. I used a mix of dark and light blue to kind of give it the look like the paint's getting worn off. Another fun trick, I have so many dirty bricks, like white bricks, because I buy them secondhand, like reused. So because of that, I have a ton of white bricks I can't even use in my builds. But for the first time in a while, I'm actually able to use those disgusting, ugly, yellowed white parts. And I did this to give the trailer home sort of a rusty look. And it actually blends really well with the other colors that go into this build, like gray, dark tan, and tan itself. This trailer house has a small little overhang on the side. This is obviously like an old model trailer house, maybe from like the 1980s, that just kind of has been sitting outside for a long time. There's like a satellite dish, and there's also this sort of like an AC unit. I've seen these on trailer houses. I don't actually know what they're used for, but either way, it adds a little punch of detail that I really like. If we take off the roof, well, the inside isn't very surprising. It's very basic, actually. A small kitchen with your basic appliances, a couch, dining table, and a bed. Well, I actually, now that I think about it, I totally forgot to include a bathroom, so that's kind of on me. If you need to poop, just do it outside, I guess. So that is the trailer house. If I were to put this on the poorometer, I would definitely give this like an 8 out of 10.
Okay, 3, 2, 1.
And we're recording. All right, perfect. So how exactly did you become rich?
Well, I kind of became rich because of TikTok fame. It all started with doing The Renegade, and I guess it just kind of escalated from there. Now I'm kind of a big deal on the internet, and I have a whole house just to record my videos.
Now, I don't know about you guys, but I despise TikTok. That's where people go to get easy views, easy clicks, easy likes. You know, YouTube is where the real OGs go. All the fight and the struggle happens here on YouTube.
I work hard for my subscribers, okay?
You can go onto TikTok right now, publish a dumb video that you recorded on your iPhone 6 Plus, and get 5 million views. So here is a expensive modern house. Now, this is like the finest of the finest modern house because it's dedicated entirely to that TikTok lifestyle. So the architecture of this house was actually really fun to design because these two side sections are actually angled. If we take the roof off, we have access to the inside. When you walk in, you are greeted by your very own butler who will personally serve you and record your TikToks despite how cringy they are.
Butler, hold the phone still. I'm only gonna do this Renegade one time, and I'm trying to get more followers.
To the right of you, you have a nice, simplistic kitchen with all the delicious, ingredients that you could possibly desire or crave to your perfect liking. And in the very back, there's a beautiful bed that you can sleep in with a bookshelf if you want to read your favorite books. And to provide some oxygen for this house, there are two potted plants. And in this final corner, this is where all the magic happens, because not only do you have a butler to record your TikToks, but you also have your own personal high-speed computer to edit and download your TikToks to TikTok.
Computer, infiltrate the minds of young teenagers.
I'm on it. Uploading your newest video, 10 tips on how to do the WAP almost fell on my face, not fake.
So there you go, guys. That was the video. Which house did you like better? You know, sometimes living simple is better. You know, you don't have to be rich to have a happy life. I want to film TikTok. You can live in a mansion and never be happy. So the choice is yours, boys and girls. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. This was actually really fun to make. Special thanks to Avaki and Olego. I'll link their channels down below for their awesome voice acting. They are the real G's. I've been finishing up my fall term for college. Now that that's over, I'm gonna get on the grind. You're gonna see a lot of videos coming up for winter break. Check out my Instagram because I have tons of updates that are gonna drop on there. And be sure to check out my other content here on the channel. Anyway, I'm gonna catch you guys in the next one. Peace out and stay spicy. I'm gonna make that my new catchphrase, by the way. Stay spicy. I like that. Actually sounds pretty cool.